So at this point, if it's not Peters and he didn't get any playing time really at all this season, I think he's got one series maybe against Purdue when they're up by a couple scores. If it's not Peters, that means the coaches have no confidence in him. And I've heard rumblings that he was going to potentially come in today if Michigan was not getting it done. That didn't happen. Even when they're down four scores late in the game, we didn't see him. Is Rutgers the right team to start a new guy? It absolutely is. And if they so, but what I'm saying is, like, if they don't put in Peters, when you saw what Okorn does, like, it's not like we have to guess what Okorn can do. We see what he does. He is not anywhere close to a Power Five conference quarterback. He is the worst consistent starting quarterback in Michigan football history. No guy has ever started three games in a row that bad in the history of the program. I'm not even going back. I'm going back to 1905, right, when they're winning national titles. 127 years, the worst quarterback we've ever had. Now, does that say Peters is worse than the worst quarterback? And this is the most important recruit in Jim Harbaugh's life. He gets it wrong in Peters, obviously. So, with all that being said, I think it's got to be Dylan McCaffrey. I don't think there's any other way. What are you holding his redshirt on? In the hopes that he's bad enough that he sticks around for a fifth year and 4 seasons from now, that he wouldn't take over the reins and go pro early after his third season or fourth season? Like, what are you holding his redshirt on for at this point? Your programming is spiraling out of control, and I don't think there's anything I've seen that's going to change it. I mean, the defense could shut teams out, and they'll still find a way to lose with this offense, as crazy as that might sound.